Hello everyone, welcome to Students Mind. This is 23rd of February and we will see all the important questions of the day. And last day, Chinta Samuksari, Cholongsaba, Rekha, Tasi Chadar, Binduji, Kartik Paul, Abhilas Kavuri, Krishna Kant, Kalyan Panuganti and others have answered the question correctly in the comment section. Let's see now question of the day, which again you have to answer in the comment section, and next day we will see how many of you answered it. Here is the question. Which body is responsible for preparation of union budget? These are the options. Read the options and then answer. And before we move ahead, we have created a Telegram channel. You can join it to get PDF of all these videos. I will share the link in the description box. Let's begin. The first question. Maku He Nagichi, which is called war dance, is performed in which state? So it is performed in Nagaland. I repeat the name. Maku He Nagichi. It is performed in Nagaland by the Sangtam tribe, and they are the warriors and they celebrate it to mark their victory. And Sadang Handu is performed and sung by women to increase the confidence in men by casting away the evil spirits from the village. Next question. The IUCN Red List has listed Bengal Slow Lorries as. So this Bengal Slow Lorries is categorized as vulnerable is one of the 9 categories which is listed by IUCN, and vulnerable category is a bit better if we compare it with endangered, extinct and critically endangered. Now what is Bengal Slow Lorries? It is a venomous primate, and traffic, which is an institution and which tracks illegal trade in species throughout the world. It has stated that this little known venomous primate may be heading towards extinction. Why? Because of high demand for its use in traditional medicines. And slow lorises are primate comprising of 8 species, and they mainly habitat in South Asia and Southeast Asia, which includes Bangladesh, Cambodia, China, India, Laos, People's Democratic Republic, Myanmar, Thailand and Vietnam. So these are the 8 countries where they habitat, and they are only known venomous primate, and their bite can lead to severe anaphylactic shock in humans. And Bengal slow lorises are the largest of all these species, and they are arboreal nocturnal species. They inhabit in tropical evergreen rainforest, semi-evergreen forest, moist deciduous forest, and they feeds on fruits and gums. And they inhabits in this forest, and that is the reason why they are mainly found in South Asia and Southeast Asia, because South Asia and Southeast Asia lies in tropical region and equatorial region. Next question. Consider the following statements about a future for World's Children Report. This World's Children Report is published by WHO, The Lancet and UNICEF. This is correct. So remember these three organizations jointly published this report called as A Future for World's Children Report. The report finds that the health and the future of every child and adolescent worldwide is under immediate threat from ecological degradation, climate change, exploitative marketing practices that push heavily processed fast food, sugary drinks, alcohol and tobacco at children. This is also correct. This means that report mainly points out to the ecological degradation, climate change and the increasing habit of fast food among the children and adolescents. So both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And the report includes a new global index of 180 countries. Out of this 180, India is ranked as 131 in flourishing index and 77th on sustainability index. So this report compares countries on different performances, which include child flourishing, which include measures of child survival and well-being such as health, education, nutrition, sustainability, with a proxy for greenhouse gas emissions and equity for or income gaps. So focus here that it also focuses on greenhouse gas emissions and income gaps, and it found that Children in Norway, Republic of Korea and Netherlands have the best chance at survival and well-being. So Norway, Republic of Korea, that is South Korea, and Netherlands, these three are the leading countries. While Central African Republic, Chad, Somalia, Niger and Mali are at the worst position. And India has also shown some improvement in some aspects, which includes health and sanitation. Next question. Consider the following statements about Ghadiyal in India. So Ghadiyal population are present in Chambal River, Gandak River, Girwa River, Son River, Ram Ganga River and Mahanadi River. This is correct. I repeat these names: Chambal River, Gandak River, Girwa River, Son River, Ram Ganga River and Mahanadi River. Mahanadi is in Odisha, Chambal is in MP, Son is in Bihar, Gandak is again in Bihar. And Madhya Pradesh has secured the tag of being country's Ghadiyal state. This is also correct. Earlier, MP got the status of being the country's Indian Tiger state, and now it has got the tag of country's Ghadiyal state. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And Wildlife Trust of India has found that MP has 1,255 Ghadiyals, which is mainly habitated in Chambal River, and it is followed by Bihar, which has 255 Ghadiyals, and they mainly habitate in Gandak River, which flows in Bihar. And Ghadiyal prefers deep, fast flowing rivers. You have to focus here because they may ask you about the sanctuary of Ghadiyal. So they prefer deep, fast flowing rivers. However, adult Ghadiyals sometimes are observed in still water as well, such as in jhil of rivers and comparatively velocity free aquatic environments of deep holes, that is called as kunds. And these Ghadiyals are categorized as critically endangered by IUCN. This shows that they are at the verge of extinction, so we need to protect them. Next question. Which state has the highest number of human deaths caused by elephants and tigers during 2014-15 and 2018-19? So it is West Bengal. West Bengal has the highest number of deaths, human deaths caused by elephants and tigers during these 5 years. And it is followed by Odisha in the number of human deaths caused by elephants, which numbers 397. And then it is followed by Maharashtra in number of deaths caused by tigers. So you have to remember these three states: West Bengal, Odisha and Maharashtra. And between this time period, 2,361 humans were killed as a result of conflict with elephants, while 510 elephants were also killed. So why these elephants were killed and how they were killed? So they were killed in incidents of electrocution, train accidents, poaching, poisoning during the same period. So they may ask you also the reasons for elephant's death. So remember this: electrocution, train accidents, poaching and poisoning are the leading causes of elephant's death. Next question. Consider the following statements about Central Consumer Protection Authority. It is to be set up under Consumer Protection Act 2019. This statement is correct. Consumer Protection Authority will be set up under this Consumer Protection Act. This act was passed last year only, and it will address issues related to consumer rights, unfair trade practices, misleading advertisements, and it can also impose penalties for selling spurious and adulterate products. So here both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. And this CPA Act, that is Consumer Protection Act 2019, had also empowered the district collectors to conduct investigations that affect the interest of consumers. So it creates a parallel authority to investigate the issues related to consumers' right. The one authority is already the district collectors, and next will be this CPA authority. This was a previous day question. Mandalay Imphal bus service will connect India and Myanmar. So it will connect basically the northeastern state with the Myanmar. Next question. Sutra Peak, is a program to research on. So this Sutra Pig is a program to research on indigenous cows, and it has five themes. These are uniqueness of indigenous cows, prime products from indigenous cows for medicine and health. Then we have prime products from indigenous cows for agriculture application. Then prime products from indigenous cows for food and nutrition. And then products for indigenous cows based on utility items. So these are the five themes which you have to remember. And Sutra Pig stands for scientific utilization through research augmentation prime products from indigenous cows. So remember this as well. And it will be led by Department of Science and Tech. So remember this organization as well, that DST will be the leading organization here. However, it has some other partners as well. These include Department of Biotech, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research, that is CSIR, Ministry of AYUSH, and ICMR, that is Indian Council of Medical Research. Now before you see next questions, let's see some key points. I have started this initiative so that no questions are left for you. Let's see. Maharashtra state has banned the centers that cultivates exotic Thai mangur fish, which is also called as foreign mangur fish or African mangur fish. Next, India and Maldives are separated by 8 degree channel. So the question may confuse you with the options of 10 degree channel, 9 degree channel, 11 degree channel, but they will be wrong, and 8 degree channel will be the right option. So India's Lakshadweep Island and Maldives is separated by 8 degree channel. Why this is news? Because Minister of Home Affairs has visited Maldives recently, and Ministry of Railway has upgraded artificial intelligence based ASK Disha. This will help to converse with railway customers in Hindi to resolve their queries. Next, Sri P. Ramakrishnan, who is Speaker of Kerala Legislative Assembly, has got the Ideal Legislative Assembly Speaker Award. So you have to remember this state, Kerala, and its speaker name, Sri P. Ramakrishnan. Next question, consider the following statements about MH-60R multi-role helicopters. India will procure 24 such helicopters from US at the cost of $2.6 billion. This statement is correct. So these helicopters will be procured from US, and 24 such helicopters will be bought by India, and it will be used by Indian Navy, not by Indian Air Force. Note here, it will be used by Indian Navy, and it will be enhanced anti-surface and anti-submarine warfare missions. So again, both these statements are correct. C is the right answer. It will replace Sea King helicopters. These helicopters were earlier used by Indian Navy, so these will be replaced. Next question, the Geological Survey of India has discovered gold deposits in which district of UP? So it is Sonbhadra. In Sonbhadra, GSI has discovered few hundred kgs of gold. Earlier there was rumors of finding 3000 tons of gold. So basically, as of now, India has 600 tons of gold in reserve, and if the news were to be correct of 3000 tons, this would have multiplied India's gold reserve up to 5 times. But the news was incorrect. Only a few hundred kilo cases of gold were found. And let's see some facts related to Sonbhadra. Sonbhadra is the second largest district of Uttar Pradesh after Lakhimpur Kheri in terms of area. So it is the second largest district of UP, and it is the only district in India which shares borders with 4 states, that are MP, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh and Bihar. So you have to remember this, that this is the only district in India sharing border with 4 states, and bauxite, limestone, coal, gold are also found here. Kaimur Wildlife Sanctuary lies within Sonbhadra, Mirzapur district of UP and Kaimur district of Bihar. Lakhania Cave and Gora Mangar or Khodwa Pahar are the ancient cave painting found at Sonbhadra. So share these videos, like the video if you find it useful. Answer the question in the comment section and subscribe to our channel. And wait for the next video. Till then, thanks a lot.